Hi, I'm Rosemary Wells. I'd like to read you a small portion of my new book, Lincoln and His Boys. Lincoln and Willie and Robert and Tad, the three Lincoln boys, and Mrs. Lincoln are traveling from Springfield, Illinois to Washington, the last trip they will ever take, and it is 5 years before the end of the war. Lincoln was a playful father. He loved wrestling with his boys. He was a wonderful father. Between stops, Father gets down on the floor with us. Dust soils the knees of his new president's suit. He doesn't mind. He plays horse with me and Tad until he says his spine is going to give out. Then the brakes squeal and the train shudders to another stop. Father tries to slide me off his back. People are waiting, he says. They want me to tell them I will make the war clouds go away. What are the war clouds, Pa? I ask astride his back, holding on to his ears. Gathering to the south, says Father, pointing to the right side of the train. I see no clouds, only bright March sun. Father goes on. Willie, the South wants to shear its states off from the rest of the country. They have their own president, Jefferson Davis, a four-flusher if there ever was one. They are determined to split the country across the middle, half slave, half free. And they'll start a war to do it. It's my job not to let them do it. How are you going to not let them, I ask? He stands up, brushing off the knees of his trousers. He takes Tad from Mama and looks out the window with me, curling his arm around my side. His eye closes, as it does sometimes, and there is no answer. I think because he doesn't quite know. Nothing about the war clouds is real until Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, and then the danger is on us. We are at the Jones Hotel with Governor Curtin. I am very bored and yawny because the day has been full of more speeches and hours of Tad and me sitting up properly in our best suits, not fiddling around or kicking. Suddenly, Father comes up to us at the children's supper in the hotel dining room. We are served vegetable soup, and Taddy takes all the peas out and puts them on the nice linen cloth. Father is wearing someone else's eyeglasses, a low crown hat, and a light gray coat. Pa, why are you dressed that way, I ask. Just a lot of chicanery, Scout, he says. Mr. Pinkerton is dressing me like a haberdasher and putting me on a fast train to Washington. But why, Pa, I ask. Who is Mr. Pinkerton? See you tomorrow, Scout, is his answer. Taddy grabs Father by the lapels of his strange gray coat until Father takes Tad's hands and places them back on the tablecloth. Eat every single one of those peas, son, he says, and spoons them up and puts them back in Tad's soup. He winks and then is gone. We board the train, Mama, Taddy, Bob, and me. Mama says nothing, but her mouth is a tight line of worry. Later, when we are rumbling through Pennsylvania, Bob comes over to my bunk. Mr. Pinkerton, Bob whispers, is a detective from Chicago with a passel of hired police to protect Father. But what happened, I wanted to know. Some copperheads in Baltimore threatened Pa's life. Well, that's what. Who are copperheads, I want to know. Bob answers, the copperheads are border staters. They've got rebel hearts. They hate real hard, and they want to kill Pa because he will stand against the slave states. I have no idea what a border state is. I suppose they can't decide if they're north or south. Our train is heading to Baltimore, Maryland. A huge tangle of copperhead moccasin snakes appears in my mind. I tell myself to lie, hands at side, stiff as a board. I tell myself if I don't move a muscle all night long, then Father will be safe from the copperheads. You wait, Willie, Bob goes on. Pa's going to be swallowed up by the war because it's coming soon. He tells me he wants to enlist in the Army instead of going to Harvard, but Mama won't hear of it. Then he snugs my blanket under my chin and turns out the blinky little gas line over my bed. In the morning, Mama is all rustle and bustle, and by that I know that Father is not dead.